So essentially, starting with the BD org structure, and so we've what essentially we call ourselves as a pan India organization. So therefore, we also have our BD structure present for all the regions. Essentially, three regions, dominantly so west, south, and north. So north is headed by Sandeep sir, and then in the south we have our regional director Mr. Amar, so who heads the overall region for south, and the BD also he is also responsible for generating new business for that region. Then Amit, who very recently joined us, have a great experience in sales, was with the HP earlier, and he'll be heading the west region. So he's based out of Mumbai. So that is the leadership for the BD. And then we have the team under these leaders. For the north, we have Sakshi, who's essentially responsible for marketing related activities, and she keep organizing various events and seminars. She's also responsible for the digital marketing and content, updating on the various social marketing forums like Facebook, LinkedIn, etc., Twitter. And then in the overall structure, we are also developing a partner network, which is essentially with the Big Four, and other than Big Four, we have other partner network also, which would help us in developing and penetrating more aggressively in the market. So that is our plan, and we would have one person who would be essentially responsible. So Ankit is identified, you've been identified for that role, to nurture and penetrate in the market, helping developing the partner network. Then I am also part of the BD team, managing few people under me, and essentially responsible for accelerating the sales in this area. Then we also have a plan to hire another person who would be also taking care for the sales, accelerating the sales in this region.
By the way, that person has been made an offer and he's joining from 1st of October.
So
he's joining us from Manpower.
Okay. So that is as far as structure for North is concerned. Further in South, I am also responsible, working closely with Amar and Karthik in South, have to nurture. So we also are identifying a person in Bangalore along with Karthik, and so together we as a team will be penetrating in that region, and would be generating more business out of South region. Then Bangalore, of course, similarly, we have plans to expand the team in Bangalore, and Amit would be directly handling and nurturing that Mumbai region. Then the overall structure, we have we have our lead generation team, which is started with Komal, and going forward we may expand this team as well. And there are sales managers. Anuj have been joined, you've been identified for helping me in the sales and the BD. Then we've also now divided the entire function and put pre-sales as a separate function, where Anubhav would be taking a lead, and he would be essentially managing all the pre-sales related work that includes your RFPs, responding to developing the presentations for sales and various such activities. So he'll be one point of contact for now for any pre-sales related activity. So any big tenders, any big RFPs that the sales team is working on, he'll be supporting the team. He'll be directly working with ops for developing the solutions and making it in the shape to be presented to the customers. So that is, and Ayush is of course
you know, going to work, you know, is working closely for accelerating, you know, the sales, and he'll be also reporting into the new person who's going to join in soon.
So essentially, if we just to add on to what Dipanch was saying is that the team has been comprehensively built, and Mumbai and Bangalore positions are to be closed as far as the senior positions are concerned. And so we are undergoing interviews. If you have any references to give, most welcome. We are considering more new people in that region. Having said that, so in all we will be almost a 12-people team with Bangalore and Bombay hiring completed, other than the seniors. I mean, other than three of us. And and our target of achieving, I mean, of an average, if you talk about, is 25 crores. Or is it 25 as a number? It's
24 crores.
So we are going by an average of thumb rule of 2 crore per person. So to achieve 24 crores, and then whatever seniors get is a bonanza over and above.
I thought it's 6 crores, no?
The 6 crore is an achievement in first quarter.
No, target for a BD is not 6.
No, I'm just saying there are individual targets each one of us. So if you talk about individual targets, so the senior person, whether it is a senior manager or any GM, so I'm talking about banks, broadly the broad numbers I'm talking about, we'll give you more specific numbers. So when we talk about senior numbers, we are talking anything between 6 to 8 crores. Okay. And when we are talking about manager, then we are talking anything between 3 to 4 crores. Am I right, Ayush?
2.5.
Okay. So 2.5 to 4 crores. And then we are talking about assistant manager or an executive role, then we are talking anything between 1 crore to 1.5 crores. Is that the right number?
Right.
Right. And the lead time is of course there. I mean, of course, we understand that you will have to learn our processes, learn our way of doing it. So definitely first 2 months is a hand-holding process where we will be supporting the whole process. But at some stage, you will have to become independent and run on your own. And see, this whole team is an acceleration team. I mean, unless and until we are not able to give an acceleration to the business, we are not justifying our role. So the whole sanctity behind this creation of this department is acceleration. Mind has been traditionally growing almost 60-70% of the business by reference, touch wood. So that shield is still going on. Okay. The purpose of creating this BD structure, for the first time it's getting created, I mean, of course it has been there, but then first time it's being scaled up. The purpose is to accelerate it, and that's why we are calling this team as an accelerator team. Okay. And irrespective of the portfolio region, I mean, we don't want to restrict anything. I mean, any business anywhere is welcome. That's the idea. So the purpose of showing this chart is that your fellow colleagues are now 12 in number, and the target is also equally big. So we will, and the purpose of organizing this session in the last 2 days and coordinating everybody together is that you understand the depth of work that we are doing, the logos that we are working for, so that when you are able to connect with the market, you are able to correlate and appreciate the logos and the depth of the work that we are doing. So so that's the idea of this. Right. And if you can, I take to the next slide.
Yeah.
If you look at, if you look at the culture from where we have grown, as I was telling you, 70% of the businesses today, even today, is coming from reference business. And the leads that BD generates, after that, when we start delivering that business, even then we get reference business out of that. It is because of the cohesiveness of the entire team today, okay? Because of working together, there is a central force of working together. If you will go to the business, whether it is finance business, HR business, IT business, you will get, you will be welcomed in every department. I mean, whatever time they have best amongst the operations that they can take out, they will try and give you. It's a part of their KRA that they have to grow that business. So you are not left alone in the company to get the business. There is a complete support and partnership that you will get. Of course, there is no end to, you will have to learn to take it to the next level. But then in the beginning, you will get that support, right? So now Dipanshu will explain this.
Sure. So further, the overall process that we follow and that we've plan to follow is that there is a lead generation which happens, which starts, so there has to be a clear focus on lead generation. So in typically in lead generation, what is the plan that there is a cold calling and rigorous cold calling that may be required because we have to accelerate the growth. So the team has to be focused on reaching out to the targeted industry markets. And they have to reach out to the right clients in that industry, and to generate leads. Other than that, of course, as we've been also referred by our customers, and you know, whenever there is a movement from a person moving from A company to B company, he then also wants our services in that company. So this is how also leads get generated in different companies. There are other ways that we have been generating the lead in past. So there are certain networking meetings, seminars, conferences that we keep attending, that we keep hosting, and not hosting but participating or sponsoring, and then we as a team attend those seminars, so where we get an opportunity to meet the industry experts and the finance and HR fraternity, and then get an opportunity to sell,
right?
And
so
represent
your best friend, in my observation, for creation of a lead is either your existing customer or your internal colleague. Believe me, in the last 3 months I'm seeing our internal teams have created, operations teams have brought in so many leads on the table. MTS, compliances, then
Puma.
Huh?
Puma also.
Puma, Grofers,
Philips,
Jabong. All of this is all our internal ops teams. Now, if we can catch hold of our ops in Bangalore, you will start getting lead from ops in Bangalore also. Okay? So that's, I mean, at least in this part of India, we are getting a lot of leads from our ops teams itself.
So ops teams is the good work that they do, and then they keep getting the references from either from their client or their friend of their client. So that is how the maximum number of leads are getting generated from the references
so
that we are getting.
So after the lead is generated, then solution design is very, very important role, because we are not selling off the shelf thing. Few things are off the shelf. But then a lot of things we'll have to tweak or suit to the client needs. And in that discussion, that comes out. And he may want something, but it'll be the same wine in the new bottle. So that solution designing, you'll have to learn from our existing BD team, Dipanshu, myself, Amar, and let's say Ayush, Anubhav. So you'll have to learn from all of us. You will have to attend lot of sessions with us to be able to catch up on how we present it. Okay. This is a joint responsibility of sales and operations, that is solutioning. So when you will have a lead in hand, you will discuss it with me or with Dipanshu, as far as this part of India is concerned, and the other part of India is concerned, you will be discussing with Amar or with Amit. So then you would need to understand from us what is, how we can solution it, how we can present it, how will we differentiate ourselves, how will we get value for money, we will offer as a value for money for the client. So all that you will have to learn from us. Okay. Once one or two meetings, and then you will be able to take it forward like that. Pre-sales is RFP, RFI, draftings, costing, etc., etc. So costing, of course, you would need hand-holding again. But RFP, RFI, there are many standard templates now we have filled up. So Anubhav will be able to drive the whole process on that. Both solution design and pre-sale, Anubhav will play a substantial role in that. And Anubhav, you will also have to keep a track of how many requests are coming to you, when have you closed those requests. So you should start maintaining your Excel file now, because the team has increased.
Already increased.
Okay, fantastic.
Anubhav supports entire pipeline from our solution pre-sale standpoint?
From a pre-sale RFP, RFI standpoint, if it's a standard proposal, more like a copy-paste, we have standard templates, so which we will be sharing with the teams, so they'll be able to create on their own. But if it is a specialized proposal, larger costing, then either me or Dipanshu will have to get into it in the beginning. And then Anubhav will also play a role in terms of his experience on this, as of now. So that's how the structure is. But if today how it works is that if any operations needs to get a proposal to an existing client, then they write to Anubhav. As far as sales and BD teams are concerned, there are standard templates. You can use those standard templates and you can submit the proposal. Whosoever you are reporting to, you should discuss that proposal with him or her before submission.
So 50 to 60% of the times, it is mostly the standard template that can be used with little tweaking that may be required to suit the customer's requirement. Other than that, there might be some new, you know, there must be a new solution that is need to be proposed to the customer, where there is of course an operations team get involved, and then you can also take in help from the pre-sales team for developing that solution, presenting that solution to the customer, and that can be jointly as a partnership proposed.
Same goes for the presentations. There are standard templates of presentation. Anubhav will have all of them. He should be able to give it to you. If the client is on the HR side, is on the finance side, there are 10 modules. If it is on X module or a Y module, similarly on the HR, if it's an A or a B or a C presentation, all templates are there. If it's an international customer, then we have to present it in a different format. If it's a national customer, we have to present it in a different format, etc. So that he will be able to give it to you. Thereafter, you can use those templates. But if you are making changes in the template, which are minor, which is fine, but if it's a major change, then please give it back to Anubhav so that he can put it into the directory.
Also, after a while, we keep updating the content in most of the presentations. So it becomes like, you know, if you have one template, then you can, of course, after a period of while, you can check with Anubhav, and, you know, if there are certain changes that have been done or made in those templates, that can be then
quickly 5 minutes you can take on the proposal number as a process. What do we follow there?
Sure. So other than in the pre-sales itself, we have been following the process for giving a proposal number to any new proposal which goes into the market. So essentially that helps us to track the number of proposals that are sent, let's say in that quarter or, you know, that YTD. And other than that, we are able to maintain a standard MIS on which the entire tracking, so that there is no repetitive of the client, there is no repetitive of the, and then there is a easy tracking of that entire.
No, because even customer comes back after 6 months at times. Aapne wo proposal diya tha, aapne to tab rate ye diya tha, aaj rate ye de rahe ho, etc. So we have to refer to the old proposals.
So there is a tracking.
So there is so who does that tracking?
So proposal number is done by Ayush. Overall MIS tracking is maintained by
Anubhav.
So what
are they supposed to do? When they make a proposal, they are supposed to send a copy to Ayush?
No, they are not supposed to send the copy to Ayush. They can take the number from Ayush. Once the proposal is submitted, then they have to report back to Anubhav of giving them the details of the value of the proposals, to whom it has been sent, what services had been offer to the customer, so that
detail that he will take. And is there a common drive in which all the proposals are saved?
Yes. So there is a common the proposal the MIS is.
That's fine, but proposals are saved.
So
we will need to create one drive by Monday within the system, wherein all the proposals can be parked, and the serial number that Ayush gives to you. Please save it as that serial number only. Right? Don't put any other name. Just put that serial number. so that if we need to search through any proposal, so anybody can search through that.
Sure.
Right?
So this can be started.
Now, this is the pre-sales. I mean, of course, I'm trying to cover it faster so that maximum thing that we can cover. There can be more questions around
it. In Mumbai, do you have operations team?
In Mumbai, we do not have operations team as of today, as large as in, as North India. So you will have to depend. I will show you the next slide. So you'll have to depend on us to begin with.
No, I was thinking by going to the office, will it help?
So it'll help.
Of, as you said, leads come from ops team.
Yes, so it'll help. So why, I'll tell you that we have operations team on the compliances side in Mumbai and on the payroll side in Mumbai. Okay, so HRO teams are there. FAO teams are also there, but they're not sitting in our office. They're sitting in client's office. So if you meet all of them, actually, they really maybe, actually those leads may be getting dropped in Mumbai today.
That's what I'm saying. If you're sitting there in the office, maybe there are some, you know, through the corridor talk, you can pick up some.
Absolutely, number one. Number two, the next get-together event will be Diwali event in Mumbai for the teams. So that's the time when you'll be able to correlate, and then they should know that who to pass on the lead to if you are in Mumbai region. As of today, those leads may be getting dropped.
So we can, what we can do here is that if we can have list of, let's say, team, because that would be very limited.
No, I'm in Mumbai. We are in Mumbai on 9, 10th and 11th now. So we'll set that process.
I have some thoughts on the Mumbai, how we'll, sure. That guy is also coming on board.
Perfect.
So before I will discuss.
Sure.
Now is the next thing is the sales negotiation and closure. Okay. So you have to, mostly what happens if it's a bigger lead, more than 50 lakh rupees per annum lead, then obviously one of the seniors will be involved with you. Either me or Saurav or Vivek or Kaushik, somebody will be involved with you. Or let's say Amar from South and Amit from here. So we will be working with you for negotiation. We'll be working with you for how to manage your way through. Having said that, the primary responsibility is going to be sales team's responsibility. You have to take it to the logical conclusion. We are your reference directory. Okay? That's basically what we are trying to say.
So sales negotiation and closures, of course, it is important for us to know that where are we striving? Do we have some insights so that we can get on to that conclusion, and then we can of course take help from the leadership team in driving that negotiations.
Now, contract finalization, we have standard template of contracts mostly. We normally share with the client our standard contract template. Naman is the concerned person who handles that piece from the legal side. He forwards it to the client with a copy to you. You have to front end with the client in terms of they have these following changes to be made, or they are not happy, or they want their own format, etc. Then you have to coordinate with Naman. Naman has a turnaround time at least of 24 hours to 48 hours once you revert to him, and then you can include him on the call if you are doing with a call with a client for any kind of contract discussions. In case you are not able to find a way through with Naman, because Naman also has a limitation in terms of his decision making, there is a process that Naman follows. The Naman follows that every agreement he puts a summary sheet on top of the agreement wherein he gets it signed from the operations head, respective operations head, sales concerned person, and then one of the directors. Okay, if it's a value above ABC category. So Naman would have to follow that process, and then you will have to support him in that process. In case something is getting delayed, I am the escalation point. Immediately come to me. Don't hesitate, because this is related with the customer. If something is falling through the cracks, something you are not able to work through, etc., feel free to come to me immediately, or write a mail to me, SMS to me. Of course, the Panchu is there. So any one of us can be contacted for an immediate thing. Now, the final thing is handover to operations. Now, this is very important piece. We are supposed to make a
Project rollout sheet.
Okay, that project rollout sheet is based on the same serial number,
which we have
given you at the time of the proposal number. That project rollout sheet has to contain. There is a standard specific format. You have to fill up that format. It has like client name, value, etc. Period, billing, first billing, implementation, billing. All those details are there. You have to fill up those details. Then you have to give that sheet to ops, finance, HR. These three people have to be given that sheet. Okay, They have a role to play in that sheet. They fill up their side of the picture in terms of number of people that will be hired, what do we need in IT, except if we need to configure any software, etc., etc.
It
goes to IT also. And then there is a P&L which is made by the ops, projected P&L which is made by the ops along with that sheet, and then it goes to finance, finally. Okay, so this whole circle is closed looped, and you will have to ensure that just by forwarding it doesn't get closed. You will have to thoda sa take a pain of ensuring that it reaches the last mile of finance, that they know what is a P&L and when is the first billing due. I'm telling you, once you set the process of billing in action, then anything doesn't stop, because it goes into the tracker of finance. But if the first billing is faulty or there are ups and downs in that, then that contract remains an ups and down for the next 2-3 months. Okay, so please ensure that you are tracking it to the last month, last day of that month for billing it also. So one of the examples is that one of our clients, Conversant in Bangalore, we implemented payroll for them. We charged for that amount, and after 3 weeks, we negotiated for treasury services contract with them, which was an additional amount, and somehow sales and operations and finance, all three did not take complete interest in it. And the client last 3 months have not been billed for the initial treasury service. They are getting billed only for the payroll service. So treasury service got added as an addendum later, but it got slipped out by everyone. So as a control point, yours is the primary responsibility. Finance is also primary responsibility, but then let it be a maker and a checker. It's very important. So that is what is handover to ops. And you should, as a personal point, I'm telling you, you should participate in transition meetings as much as possible. A, it'll give you a learning. B, next time when you are making a pitch to a new customer, you will know how to make a solution. What problems you face when you actually get down to execution. When customer will know that the person coming and selling knows all of this, he will be very receptive to you. Otherwise, their receptivity is limited to, ye toh sales se aaye hain. You know, but whereas if you know you are the subject matter, then their receptivity is very different. Okay, so participate in transition meetings with operations so that you get a hold of the subject.
I would extend it a bit and say that maybe even every quarterly, if there's a review meeting or something, if BD participates in that, it helps us, because we have got so much to sell to the client. Maybe we ended only with the payroll, but we've got some 5 other things to sell.
So the point
about lead that you are making, the lead is actually coming from, you said, customer. That customer lead has to come from the BD also, not just operations. So that first milestone of the bill and all that is very critical. But also continuous basis, I think we have to keep participating in some kind of executive review or whatever is there. Operations team, I'm sure, has a regular review mechanism. In one of, at least quarterly once, we should participate in that. Then we know ground realities, what is going on, what is working, not working, what the issues are. We become educated as a BD. Plus, it helps us to seed. Okay, now this is payroll is done. How about HRIS? How about getting introduced on the finance side, right? Or on the recruitment side, or on the IT side. So we've got many things to say.
So essentially what you're saying is, own your client. If you own your client, then obviously,
Leads will follow.
Relationship
management. Especially what I saw in the last 2 days, that we have got at least maybe 6 or 8 different products. And they are, of course, under finance, FAO and HRO and IT. But under each one of them, there are again a wide variety of things that we can sell. Okay. And our client engagement seems to be mostly on a few, maybe 2-3, right, most of the time. We enter with something. But after, you know, as we say in sales, that land and expand. So this is only what we are doing is landing. After landing, then expand also. That's the point.
Very good point. And to be honest, we are trying our best. But if that becomes a process, then...
Because I'm seeing in BD, you have a very methodical process. Most companies, BD is not like this. There is no slide at all. This kind of a slide doesn't exist. People are just run like what we call typically as headless chickens, you know. Mm-hmm. Every day morning, they're just running. So, but however, mine seems to be very structured in everything that we do. We are a process automation company. We follow the process even for sales. So we should just put this as part of the process.
Sure. Thank you. This is courtesy Dipanshu, by the way. Must appreciate it. Now this is what we are trying to say is that who will you take help from? So if it is F&A, then Saurabh is taking a very is supporting this day in, day out. He's available. Kaushik is the next in command, and then solutioning side, Ramesh is available. So at least in North India, if it's a larger deal, then both Ayush and Dipanshu try their best that in the larger deal, if it's FAO, then either Saurabh is participating or Kaushik is participating or I am participating. You know, so that we are able to give that impression to a client of whatever he needs in one go, rather than just that it falls because the client is not able to appreciate about the whole process. You guys may be very fresh into this whole system. So that's why these names have been given. The introductions have happened with all three of them in the last few days, last yesterday basically. So you will have to build your relationships that you can pick up a phone and speak to them. On the HRO side is Vivek, Dinesh could not come here, he had to travel. Tamal and Ravdeep for their respective, we have mentioned respective area of operation for each one of them. So you can connect with each one of these people and take your help. On the IT side is the bottom part, Sunil and Manish. So your primary connect will be with Sunil, and then if it is to do with something to do with the development, then will be Manish. Okay, so solutioning side will be with Sunil. Dipanju, ye niche wale naam kya hai? Puneet, Sunil, Ajay.
So they are key process specific owners in each area. So any specific requirement that you may not require a full time support, or maybe some understanding of any process, or maybe you may have a client to whom you want to have a call to be made for taking the understanding or explaining the processes. So these are the key people who are operating, who are the managers who've been handling since long these processes. So let's say AP, Rico related processes.
Puneet actually presented yesterday.
Puneet, you've already met. Similarly, AR, Sunil has been handling for large customers. SSC is our...
Ajay was not there yesterday, therefore Kaushik played that role.
Yeah.
So, but we will introduce you to Ajay. Vasu was also not there. Suraj, Varun, these guys were not there. Payroll mein Manish Jain.
Manoj
is the person who's just joined.
Yeah. Right.
So Manoj, you guys have already met. Anshu is running that compliances piece right now. Priyanka is already sitting with you. Sumit was sitting in the morning, and then Kailash, you could not meet today, but yes, in due course you will meet him. So these are the people. What Dipanshu, what you're trying to say is, if they have any query on the subject, they could call them.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Anytime.
On the recruitment side, I was a little confused. Priyanka's role versus Ravdeep and.
In fact, recruitment is not here. Recruitment
both seem
is
to have
defend.
Said the same thing.
Huh?
Right. So okay, let me clarify it, and Priyanka can add to it. Priyanka is responsible for the HRO side in terms of learning and development, or in terms of appraisal management, that kind of processes. And Nitin is
only
recruitment. Am I right, Priyanka?
So in fact, recruitment is not here. However, there is a bucket of recruitment which falls under Nitin.
Right.
So we can.
Now this is 23.5 crores is the target for the year, and this has been broken into 14 and 10 crores approximately under each of these categories. This has been further reflected as quarter-wise targets that we wish to achieve.
And these are based on the past trends. Typically, we are able to achieve 35% of the total target in the quarter one, and similarly quarter two and quarter three are 25-25%, 25-30% is easily achievable. Quarter four is little slow, wherein we can target to have 20% of the total target.
See, this is our target for booking or revenue?
So we are booking.
Okay. Let me tell you, our services are such which are needed in the market very, very aggressively.
Mm-hmm.
So you really don't have to hard press yourself in terms of selling it. You're just making a right connect, making a right solution pitch to him, and most of the work is done. Then it comes to reference. Can you deliver what you say? Then touch wood, we have good references, we have good logos to who we are working with, we have good teams who present themselves. So mostly, I would say wherever it's the large contracts and we all pitch together, we almost get 100% wins. Almost get 100% wins. It's only middle level or small value contracts where there could be competition, there could be some rate related wars that others may be playing, that's all. Otherwise, mostly it's a straight walkthrough after the first initial introduction. So you really are on a good wicket as far as driving the whole sales is concerned. So that's where we are. And anything you want to talk, or I should go to the next slide? These are the win. This is the win for the first quarter. So against a target of 8.22 crores, we have got 8 crores. And out of which 6 crores has come from HRO and 1.5 crores have come from FAO. But on a company level, we have achieved our target in terms of 8 crore versus 8 crore approximately. And top wins are reflected here: Kane, Feedback, G4S, Crawfords, Uninor, yeah. Yamaha. These are the large contracts, just as a reflection, worth about 6 crores. Sorry?
Uninor is HRO.
That is my mistake. So it's mentioned in the FAO, it's HRO.
Actually, G4S contributed in a significant way.
Yeah.
Significant way.
If it didn't almost have 50%. That, it would have fallen quite short.
Yes.
So in fact, all together, these 6 accounts contribute 80% of the total revenue that we've achieved. So essentially, if we see, if we have larger tickets, then, you know, the target that we set can be easily achieved. So, and Crawfords similarly, I mean, it was just, though it's a startup organization, however, it is able to contribute. I mean, now we've been able to achieve over 1 crore of a business. We've signed up over 1 crore of a business. So, we started with the small piece, I think, worth 30, 40 lakhs, and we've been able to scale up, adding more business with them.
So, essentially, the ticket size that we kind of look forward to is anything in excess of 20 lakhs to 25 lakhs in a contract
per annum.
That's an average ticket size we look forward to. And what excites us is something like anything in excess of 50 lakhs to 1 crore is when you get an excitement from the company. Is that what you basically go after?
And the booking values that we saw, all of that is 1 year
annual numbers. Otherwise, if you look at it, these contracts are typically 3 years to 5 years.
But when we measure only 1 year annuity contracts.
So if this 8 crore worth business, this will be worth at least 24 crores minimum. This is the wins in the RPO, that is recruitment process, that we have done in this period. These are revenue projections which we'll get. We've got so many positions in the market, and this is broadly driven by Akshat. The entire RPO, he's focused on RPO leads only, and so this is the
reporting to Nitin.
So about 70 lakhs worth business has been kind of sourced in the first quarter. Now this is where, like, G4S is a common customer. So we sold payroll and we got RPO later.
Correct.
Episodes, the same thing. We currently deliver payroll and we have got the RPO. However, the reverse is not true. All the RPO clients, we have not got anything else as of today. But we'll have to work on that.
Just a thought, can we create all our customer base, install base? Say with who's buying, using what, and then just kind of drive a rhythm.
Another name we could add to that list is probably Fastadia. So we've made a breakthrough. We've entered them through our other services. Yeah.
So now in talks regarding RPO.
Right. Stadia is another customer like that. What is this slide all about, if you can?
So this was YTD for June actually. So we have an annual budget. And
okay, so we've achieved 8 crores, we've dropped 5 crores, and we have in progress leads worth 10 crores as on first quarter. So the last number, this 10 crores is the leads which are in hand, 8 crores closed, and we dropped about 5 crores. So that was in the first quarter.
What is the current pipeline?
Current pipeline would be little more than what is depicting here, so maybe another 20-15% over a period of past 2 months,
so
which have been added.
Working on, is it like 10 crores or more?
Would be close to 12 crores.
12 crores.
11 to 12 crores, easily. So this was YTD till June 2015, and since then we've opened new deeds as well. Which are not reflecting in this number, so now this must have reached to almost closure to 12 crores.
And this 12 crore lead is essentially so far is driven by 4 or 5 people, and now with the expanded team, we expect it now that it should have a larger effect.
Most of the pipeline would be not.
North and south.
But driven by the
driven by north, but it will be north and south. Most of the leads are generated from north today, as of today. This is.
I think that pipeline will need to be built for correct.
Yes.
At 50% ratio, we can close about 6 CR out of the 12. Our run rate is like 8, 7, 8 per quarter.
So that's what we have to work more. That's
from a real perspective.
So from a, that's why that forum that we are participating in, we have to link more and more there so that we can then approach them to build
before
the pipeline.
Before I forget, Sandeep, I need business cards.
Okay.
If I have to.
Aapka vote theek hua?
Nahi hua, but at least he saw the problem.
So suggestion?
Suggestion, he said he will come back to me.
Okay.
I have his number. So now
okay.
I can talk to him.
Okay.
Nitesh Saxena.
If he can do it before he leaves.
No, meeting requests are aapke. Wo bhi nahi ja rahe na. You have to go from the mind ID.
Sure.
Draft karke padega.
So this is a quarter two plan. We are, as we've already discussed, the overall target numbers for quarter two, which covers almost total of 3.75 crores in FAO and 2.9 crores in HRO. Almost 6 crores is the total target number for quarter two. And
so we basically broke our target into person by person. Right, that time when we were deciding this, so that time we had 3 people or 4 people in the team. So we broke it into Dipanshu, Ayush, South Region, management team, Anubhav. You know, that's how we broke our targets too for the second quarter. That this sheet is basically a reflection of that. These are the proposals which are running.
So that 9 crore that you saw, these are depiction of the larger leads which are running in FAO and in the HRO proposals. However, I think we've all able to add few more leads in the larger ticket size and
let's see. So our target is that we at least close these proposals in this period, and more leads have to be added in this.
So for us, there is nothing called vertical, correct? So horizontal solution, it can go anywhere. Telecom, bank.
Anything.
Any businesses.
Yeah,
business.
Yeah. Right. The client should just pay. These are some of the targets that we had kept in this quarter. One was cross-selling in this quarter that we had kept at a target. These are the industries we had kept as a target to approach in this quarter. Serco is one of our competition. They are going through a reorganization patch right now. So their customers were was our target. And hiring new BD team and training them was our target. So fourth point seems to be still achieving some bit.
Right. I think even Bangalore looks better now.
Yeah. Then this is how we had broken it into the region-wise targets. This is north, and we broke it into the people. Then west, then that time the new BD person in Mumbai was to join in mid-August. That time we had made this. This is south, and then this was the total target. So that's how we had kept this target region-wise, broadly, per quarter.
These are for Q2?
Q2.
The numbers.
These are numbers for the Q2 or for annual?
Annual.
These are annual numbers.
These are all annual numbers.
Annual numbers.
15 crore, rest.
I think you need to. We did get some contracts with these old separation
yes.
and all that. So you need to update those. I can't do that. You need to do that. Make sure they have the right numbers.
No, even Chennai, that. Mohit's company.
That only happened yesterday.
That's quarter two.
Yeah.
So that's quarter two actually.
But in quarter one also we did do some deals, you know.
So they must be covered.
You say zero.
Achha, that way.
Yeah. Nothing is covered.
So
quarter one.
Okay.
You did some deals in quarter one?
Yeah, episodes.
Episodes. Okay.
We sold them separation. We sold them HRIs.
So that is in quarter two only.
That
is booked under quarter two only.
Okay.
So those are booked. I have a track of it. Those
okay.
are booked under quarter two only,
okay.
and that would be reflected in the closure of quarter two.
Okay.
And then again, we can have a similar session or similar kind of a MIS quarter
two. No doubts, Chennai Karthik has to work hard to ensure that he achieves his targets in quarter two at least, if not in quarter one, right?
Any help that you? See which will help because here of course north is as we've been developing through the references also and there is marketing have also started working for generation of new leads in the in that area. In fact Sakshi has been planning for both the regions for west as well as for south and you know there are certain keywords which have been now
that
which will be
recently. We are the ones who told about that.
Yeah.
Actually,
Sakshi
I got those tips from this my friend here, and he told me all these things, and immediately I wrote out to Sakshi.
Right. So Sakshi has worked hard on that.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
She.
But only recently it got implemented. We have to give it some time to.
Yeah. So similar work has been she has been doing for the West region as well.
Okay.
So that we get so let's say any Mumbai specific search is happening or any Chennai.
For anybody, if you Google from Chennai or Mumbai. There you won't get mine. It's coming only under Delhi, which is what we alerted her, and then she took a month to get that sorted out, and got sorted out recently. In fact, you know, and now we come at the top two. So anybody out there who has a need who goes and Googles, now at least we figure over there. Other than we're figuring them actually earlier, which is why we're probably working so hard.
So when is that which have been happening other than
on LinkedIn Sunday. I spoke to that guy in Pune. They are ready to do it. We can have a little more detailed conversation with them.
Sure.
They have a methodology for generating leads for India.
Let's do that.
So then we don't have to do cold calling. They will do all the cold calling. They'll give us the leads, our big teams can then straight away go and attack a qualified customer.
Sure.
Time utilization.
Absolutely. See, what will happen is on a day-to-day basis, I may get caught in many things. So my response time versus, let's say, Dipanchu's response time, they will always be better. His response time will always be better.
I don't think so. That is not what my experience is.
Okay.
So if I need anything from mine, I send a message to Sandeep. Next minute, I get a response.
Achha, okay. So, okay, it's a feedback for Dipanchu.
No, I haven't tried Dipanchu yet. I'm going to try now. Okay.
Sure.
Since Sandeep mentioned,
So what I'm trying to say is that in case we see that, let's say we need some next level things to go on, let's say Pune thing as an example, and if we are convinced about it, just move them along. I may take one or two days to take decision making, but then
other we can talk to the Dipakshu and then take and decisions and
move forward with this. These are some of the things which we did in the which we are supposed to do in the second quarter. One is make some membership of the forums to attend the more and more seminars, and do one industry promotion event, which we are doing in Mumbai in September. And also more to do with the digital branding and marketing, which Sakshi has taken initiatives like that SEO search criteria and like Amar is suggesting. So all that she has aggressively taken on. So that she has been doing from first quarter, and then the results have started showing in the second quarter. So now Amar, in at least in North India, I on an average see at least two or three leads per week from net that Sakshi gets. It comes to the sales ID in mind, and then Sakshi distributes it to the respective person.
Right.
And I hope that for Chennai and West also we start building. I mean, of course, subject to how the whole thing goes there.
No, sure. I mean, with the culture of startups and other things coming, there are, like you said, is a badly required need. And, I'm pretty sure that this will be. In fact, even today, Karthik told me something, actually. I'm a little confused about whether it came through that or through another customer.
Which one?
So from Grofers director,
yeah.
I got one call. Actually, it's from the company name is Forces. It's an IT company and it's a startup company. Now currently they are having around 20 plus the employee strength, and in another 3 months they are expanding to 50, and in a year 100. So they're looking for this payroll solution part.
In Chennai?
Yeah, in Chennai.
So when you say Grofers director means what?
Grofer
references.
Has referred Grofer. To Priya of this company.
Grofer has referred it to some Forces customers.
So how did he get your? She get your number?
Through website in Chennai.
She's already taken the company name.
Fantastic.
And actually, one thing they asked directly, Amasa's name only.
Okay.
Director has referred
Amasa's
name.
Okay.
I'm very confused about. I don't know my face in front of
Grofer. No, but your name
no,
appears
but,
on the website.
What would have happened is, I'll tell you, let's say Saurav would have attended some meeting and they would have said, who is your director in Chennai?
Okay.
So Saurav would have given your name.
No, also on the website it is available.
It is available.
Right.
So his number is available on the website. Sir's name is
so
available.
So what have you, now let's understand this example. When did you receive that call?
So today around 2 o'clock.
What did you do after that?
So I called her and I said tomorrow morning I'll be there, and
perfect.
She said she will be sharing the. I shared my mail ID also to her, so she said she will be sending a mail about the address because they are working.
No, that's fine. So now when you go there, one is their requirement, which is payroll.
Yes.
What else will you talk to them?
So since during my discussion itself, what she directly spoke about the costing point of view. So she said mainly we want the proposal immediately. So then only I said these are all our offering, and if you want any compliance related activities, because you said it's a startup, so we have to register you through for PF, ESI and all statutory related things. So it's better if I can come and show all the details to you. Then we'll be able to understand your requirement based on that.
Right. So what I'm saying is pricing is secondary in such cases. In all startups, pricing is secondary.
How did the talent
okay.
Lead generate?
If we see a scale up in that startup, if we see that startup has been funded by an ABC, then pricing is not a barrier to close the
pipeline.
Okay. But the point is that what you should do is you should build the confidence in them that you can
so that
not only take payroll up, you can take from us compliances from us, shops and stuff, that is the bare minimum they will need. Recruitment from us, they can take accounting from us, they can take accounting related compliances from us. So so first is their need, but then you should have a target to
overall.
Overall.
So this is it.
Just one thing. HCL Talent Lab, we signed in Q1. Okay, that should have been updated at the very least.
That's a joint partnership between North and South, so that's fine. I mean, so we can share it with South. So this is it. So any queries, any doubts, any thoughts that you guys have, feel free to ask. Of course.
Do we charge the client upfront as an 100% fee in advance, or is it like milestone based?
Yeah. So there will be one separate rate card, referral rate card, we will be sharing with you so that you are able to understand it. Having said that, just to answer your question, in most of the cases, we do not charge them upfront. Okay. Our business is normally a long-term business, right? And we sign the contract with them, we charge them an implementation fee, for which some 5-10% we can charge upfront just as a token. And otherwise, when we implement, we charge them as the first fee. And once we start delivering, then the monthly billing. So normally it is like that. Okay. But if we see that the customer's credit credit worthiness or the reputation in the market is of concern, then obviously we will be discussing more, and then we will take a different stand there.
So in case of one-time assignment, then
there is a different mechanism. So then it is a milestone based. So 20% let's say in the implementation stage, starting stage, then remaining in the completion of first milestone, and then on completion of the complete task. So these are typically when you're doing one-time related activity, but mostly the services are recurring in nature, and these are for long-term contract.
So let's say fixed assets is an example that Dipanshu is referring to. If fixed assets we are pitching for, it's a one-time assignment which normally lasts 1 quarter maximum, 2-3 months. There we have a milestone-based payment, advance, then on completion of ABC, and then the next level. But if it is a recurring activity, then what I was telling you earlier is what?
So when you said that we need to ensure that the first billing happens, so that means that the solution has been provided and it's up and running.
Yes,
so
the solution, that is what I'm saying.
First billing.
So whether it's the implementation or whether it's the first month regular billing, that you have to ensure. Just walk up to the finance and understand ke billing kya ja rahi hai, kya nahi ja rahi hai. That's important. So that's it. That's what we wanted to do. And then the last slide is more about. That's how we present it, and that's how we work, is that the BD team is an extension of an operations team only. So we are essentially the ops team, and we are working with them to help them accelerate their business. So that's our motto and objective. And there are many leads which ops is closing on behalf of BD. There are many leads that which ops is bringing. So essentially they also track their own MIS. So we try, and Anubhav tries and ensure that our MIS is one. There is one review, one MIS, and we are all talking about taking it forward rather than getting into the MIS differences, if any. Okay, so that's the idea. That's it. Anything else you guys are looking forward to, feel free to ask, suggest.
There's a reference fee for every service which you are offering, which can be, of course, changed depending on the requirement of the
customer. Sorry, coming in.
I'm saying that there must be a reference fee, like let's say the client asks for a costing. what will the services cost? Is there a reference as in as you're saying the rate card?
Yeah, so we will share with you a reference rate card which will help you build a discussion with a client, right? So that rate card we will have to share. Maybe if you can take a separate session with them in the next 2 days, whenever convenient, so that they are able to build onto that rate card.
And like post the initial discussion, do we go back to the ops team, try and understand what kind of manners would be required? Then maybe quote a comprehensive.
Yes. So there are some products which are standard, like payroll. We have a standard rate. Okay. There are some products where you need to build a costing sheet. So costing sheet also has a format typically which we follow, and there you need to work with ops team to ensure that the numbers are in sync with what they think, and then you complete the costing sheet. So in the costing sheet there is a, besides the direct cost, there is a sitting cost of the people who are going to be running this operations. There is management fee, there is overheads, there is a profit margin. So that's how that costing sheet is made. So Dipanchu will have to take you through a few examples so that you guys are onto the same speed with that.
Most services we've able to drive on a
standard cost model. So let's say payroll, compliances, AP, VHT per invoice kind of a rate. So all OPEX model, transaction based model we'll be able to drive. However, still with the complex nature of services and solutions that we pitch to the customer, there are at times when we have to come on to a specific costing for that project, and that has various parameters including the resource cost, IT cost as explained. So various cost parameters, and then adding on to the overheads, margins, and we drive on the transaction based rating for that.